Hi everyone. So today we have Mr. Neeraj Hatti Singh, who is the MD and the founder at Signet Infotech. He needs no introduction. So we'll straight away shoot questions at you, sir. So, amidst all the rumors that were there that the e-invoicing is going to be delayed and it might not get implemented on time and, various other expectations and hopes of the delay, it has finally been implemented. And I just want to understand from you that where did India stand before the implementation of e-invoice and after the implementation of e-invoice?
E-invoicing implementation, I'll put it across, has been one of the biggest transformational change that has happened into any country, or I would put it across into the tech technology field, it is there. So it gives a clear visibility. Means like invoicing are already there through different frameworks across 133 countries as the last count I was aware of it. But it's not done in a fashion that has been done into India. So there are still few countries where it is kind of the invoices are being registered onto a centralized platform, and then it is recorded and then a confirmation has been sent across. But the way it has been done in India is unique. The way it is going to make a difference in terms of implementation and the ability to take the credit of the B2B invoice, it's going to be different. The way the data would be available with the government and the way the e-implementation will help to rule out the kind of bogus invoices from the system. It's very, very transformational and it's going to make a big difference. And the most important is that people thought that even in this pandemic, it's impossible to implement such a kind of system. But for 500 crore plus companies, it has been implemented. It has been implemented successfully. And most of the companies are seamlessly generating invoices. Now, this is a great creditability to the GSTN, to the government for their willpower, to NIC for an excellent system, and to the entire ecosystem like us, yeah, who help the clients get online. So I think it's a great, great success overall into the whole process.
Surely, sir. So my next question actually is very much related. So as you rightly said, the government has played a very important role and to keep the things smooth. So we understand even for e-invoicing to be a success, not only the government, but there are multiple stakeholders as a GSP, as you mentioned, or as a taxpayer, or the government themselves, the three different portals that people are working with. So they have strived a lot in order to make this a great success as it is today. So would you like to just throw some light on what as a GSP, how you prepared and how did you take up things at your end to make sure that, all your clients were able to generate e-invoicing at the right time?
So for any such system to work seamlessly, the ERPs are always the maker system, and there is the NIC where you need to register, or the invoice portal where we need to register. There always has to be a checker system in between. So we did not kind of only work as a checker system, but we also facilitated the seamless integration from the GSTN portal, from the, I would say, the client's ERP to our checker system, that is our ASP solution, to the invoicing system, and ensuring that the same data can be forwarded to GSTN or it can be forwarded to the for e-way bill as well. So we integrated all the three systems into a single platform and gave the facility to the end clients to seamlessly register and get their invoices generated. So this is a kind of a major contribution that GSPs like us who have done into the system, and providing that technological backbone, providing and identifying where things are going wrong, identification in terms of errors, identification in terms of streamlining the integration process. These are the things which we were involved into it. And that is a role that the GSPs have played, and that is a role which has helped for the seamless integration into the whole process.
Very well said, sir. Yes, sure. So we have come across a large volume of data as well when it comes to e-invoicing with our clients. So the next question actually to you was that how has Signet eased the accessibility for generating the e-invoicing? But I think you have already answered it by saying that, we have provided a very seamless integration with the ERP systems till the government portals. Yes. So the next question would be, how successful as Signet were we in order to just compare that where we stood from the first week till now? So any highlights on that?
Yeah, it was a great, great achievement, and achievement which I am not able to understand very clearly in terms of the numbers. I would say the data that is available to us, which was shared with us from 1 to 19, clearly states that around 18 to 19%. So the data which was shared with us said that around 2.4 crore invoices were generated from 1 to 19th on the NIC portal. Yes. And about 18 to 19% of those invoices were generated, yeah, were routed through our solution. So that was a great proud moment. And what NIC had suggested that about 82% of the total invoices were routed through the GSPs. And so this, from the GSP standpoint also, we have a very, very high percentage that has been routed through us. At the same time, the end of the month count, which has been known to me, it is around 4.95 crores invoices, which was generated on through the NIC portal. And out of that, around 88.15 lakh invoices were routed through our portal. So this is a great achievement. Again, we are talking about around 19% of the invoices which were routed through our system. So it's a great achievement. And luckily, we have all the large volume clients. So the clients depend on us when there is a large volume involved, and they rely on Cygnet solution or capabilities in terms of being able to handle that large volume. So we had our challenges, we had our breakdowns, we had a lot of escalations from the clients, but I think we were able to get everything done with. And today the systems have kind of streamlined a lot. Still, new challenges come in, new kind of issues come in, but it is nothing compared to the first week. So I think things have cooled down a lot. Things have streamlined a lot, and the production are not suffering. The supply chain is not suffered, and the people are able to dispatch their material on time. So this is a great achievement for the entire ecosystem, not only for Cygnet, but even for the clients, the ERP providers, and on the government side, from the NIC and the invoice portal, it has been a great success.
Yes, at the start, like, we have been really proud of this transition that we were a part of. So definitely the next question to you is, you know, there has not been any formal notification, but there is a press release at various platforms, which also says that all the taxpayers, whether they are 100 crore and above or in a phased manner, even all the taxpayers, whether they are small in size, everyone will have to start generating the e-invoices. So what has you would be advising them in order to prepare for this e-invoicing transition?
See, I think when the discussion was happening that from 1st of October, e-invoice will come for 500 crores plus company, people were in denial that it will get postponed, it will be cancelled, or in this pandemic time, it will not happen. But the government had the mindset and their willpower to ensure that this happens. And we as a community, we as an ecosystem, we're also having that mindset that no, we can make it happen, and we did make it happen. And whatever our interactions has been with the government, whatever they have spoken on the public forum, it is very clear that from 1st of January, invoicing will come for maybe 50 crore plus company or 100 crore plus company. And from 1st of April 2021, it will come for everyone. So my request to all companies would be, prepare for it, be ready, because it is going to come. And I will honestly tell you that it is going to simplify things for you. It will smoothen out the things for you. And not only from the sales side, but even when you have to take the credit on the purchase side, it will make things very simple for you. So be prepared, be ready. It is going to be done. Sooner the better, because we would be able to kind of streamline the entire ecosystem quickly.
Very true, sir. So thank you. I think you've addressed most of the questions that we have been receiving day in and day out. And next, for everyone, we will also be bringing a series of the do's and the don'ts so that you do not miss on anything you have to take care before actually the implementation of the e-invoicing starts for at least the other taxpayers. So we'll quickly see you in the next video series that we have. Thank you.
Thanks, Kesha. Thanks a lot. See you in the next one.
Thank you.
Thank you.